I'm going to talk about Docker images. What a Docker image is, when you might want to use it, what its uses are, and then also what its difference is from some other alternative methods. And so in short, a Docker image is going to be a unit where it contains all of your source code, all of your libraries, dependencies, everything that you need to execute your application or service. And with this Docker image, you're able to run a container, which would then execute your application or service. And then you can access it through ports that you've opened up, or you can access it through a shell session. And one thing that you may be asking yourself is, how is Docker different than a virtual machine? You may have used Vagrant, VirtualBox, VMware, or something similar. They allow you to isolate the services, but there are a few major differences that make virtual machines a lot less efficient. For starters, you have to use the entire guest operating system for each application that you want to isolate. For example, if you had a Ruby on Rails application, but then you also had a PostgreSQL service, and then you also had a Redis service, then you would have to have three full-blown operating systems up and running to have those isolated. Or typically, you could have them all in one virtual machine, which we'll talk about in a little bit as to why I really don't like that method either. And another alternative from using Docker or a virtual machine is to use your host OS. So it doesn't matter if you're running Windows, Linux, or Mac OS, you would be able to install the Ruby runtime and then do all your development as you would. But doing something on the host operating system does have some drawbacks, and primarily one of those is if you have to support multiple applications that are all running different versions of Ruby, but then they also have different version dependencies, then it can get to be a real nightmare to support multiple applications, especially if you're having to switch between them multiple times a day. So I've been in situations where I had to support older versions of MySQL, and then I had a few applications that were developed using a newer version of MySQL. And so bouncing back between both of those, even a couple of times a day, was a real pain. But with Docker, you can essentially create a Docker Compose file, which would have all of the dependencies and their specific versions all laid out within this YAML file. You can then execute the YAML file to spin up all of the Docker images as containers. And the nice thing about this is it doesn't matter what your host operating system is. You can do this whether you're on Windows, Mac OS, or Linux. You're able to use the exact same YAML file. You would just have to have the Docker executable installed on your primary operating system. And so even with the version dependency isolation, which is really nice, another reason why I really like Docker is that it can be a great playground area to test out an application or some other kind of project. Whether you're doing freelance work for a company, you can keep everything isolated into a container. And once that job is done, you can then archive it away. And you're not wasting your disk space with any of the forgotten dependencies that you had to install for that particular project. Another nice benefit of Docker is that you're able to share your YAML file and your application code with really anybody that you want to. So essentially, you can provide a one-line script that they would run if they already have Docker installed, and it will get that application fully up and running, so you don't have to then do anything except start to work on it. And in the recent years, Docker has gotten a lot better about the host file support. So you're able to then take a Ruby on Rails application that's stored on your host computer within a folder. You're then able to spin up a Docker container which has a mount to that project's code. So any changes that you make locally on your host's machine, meaning that you can still use all your favorite editors that you like to use and you already have configured, you can then see those changes reflected on the Docker container. Some other benefits with Docker that you're able to do is to onboard new developers quickly. I've been in situations before where we had to spend time getting a new development machine up and running, and it literally took the entire day. And that's a waste of everyone's time involved if they had just used Docker instead. In that particular situation, you would just be able to run a couple of scripts, get Docker up and running, and then get the application up and running, and the developer can then spend the rest of their time configuring their editor, installing other applications that they like to use. but being able to dive into your code day one with something like Docker would be possible. And another great benefit that you're able to do is when you build out your images. So let's say if you're developing an application, you got it to the point where you think you're ready to deploy that particular version. Well, with Docker, you can then build your Docker image, which has all your application code. It has everything it needs, the dependencies, gem installs. It has everything packaged together. You're then able to take that Docker image and push it up to a remote registry. And depending on your deployment workflows, you're then able to take that Docker image that is up on this remote registry and then deploy it to your production environment. So your production environment would also be used in Docker. It's going to take those exact same Docker images that you had just pushed up, and it's going to use those to then deploy and then run your Rails application on the production environment. The nice thing about that is that if you know that you have built a good Docker image, you push that particular image up to the registry, then you don't have to worry about any kind of compatibility issues on the host server that's running your production environment. It's just going to work because everything is isolated within this Docker image. And with any kind of conversation about Docker, or at least any kind of honest conversation about Docker, it's also important to realize when Docker is not going to be the right fit for your particular use case. So if you have application speed, which is 100% critical, there is a small overhead on the performance of Docker. And if you're also developing a graphical user interface, and for all intents and purposes, it really doesn't have any kind of exposed API, then Docker isn't really going to be the right fit for there. And also if you have some different use cases, for example, where you are developing on an x86 platform, but then you're going to be deploying to a ARM64, then you might run into some issues there as well. But with that kind of difference, you're going to run into some issues anyways. But overall, I've been using Docker for the past several years for my application development, and it has been a game changer. I still keep a local instance of Ruby installed on my host operating system, and I primarily use that to create new Rails applications, to jump into an IRB console if I need to real quickly, or for just having some general scripts that I use on a day-to-day basis. But as far as all my Ruby on Rails application development goes nowadays, it is all done in Docker. So if you have been developing on macOS or Linux or Windows, and you haven't been using Docker, I definitely recommend that you give it a shot. Taking an existing application and Dockerizing it really isn't too difficult. It takes a bit of time. There is some learning overhead to it, but I think that it is a well worth adventure if you are up for the task. There's a lot of great tools out there and a lot of good resources for learning how to use Docker and to manage it. One of my favorite is CTOP. CTOP allows you to see all of the running containers that you have currently running on your host operating system. I've also recorded several different Drift and Ruby episodes about Docker, both for Docker on Windows, and then how I'm currently developing with Docker on macOS. So be sure to check those out too. Well, that's all for this video. Thanks for watching. For more videos, check out driftandruby.com.